In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss about determination of length and width of phloem fibers. Before getting into the tutorial, here I've raised some of the questions to be answered. What is an eyepiece micrometer? What does it mean to calibrate eyepiece micrometer? Why is calibration necessary? How do we do it? If a specimen or object is large in size, we can measure by using normal or ordinary ruler. If the size of an object or specimen is very smaller in size, that is in micron size, it is impossible to measure by using ordinary ruler. In such case, we'll be using a specialized ruler, what we call as eyepiece micrometer. And this eyepiece micrometer is embedded within the lens. So very first, the eyepiece micrometer, when it is focused in low power, it will be looks like this. It shows a divisions in numbers, 100 divisions in number. Now, if I focus and size of an object, unidentified object under low power, and if you are measuring the length, it shows, for example, 2 eyepiece unit. Now I'm switching the lens to high power, that is 40x, and now I'm measuring the size of the same object. Now it shows 8 eyepiece unit, which means the size of the object is not physically enlarged or changed. Only we are switching the eyepiece micrometer from low power to high power. So which shows that the ocular measurements corresponds to length of the object, which depends on the object to lens that is being used. That's the reason why we are calibrating the eyepiece micrometer. So for calibrating eyepiece micrometer, we have to use a specialized ruler, what we call as a stage micrometer. The stage micrometer is a factory made ruler, which is the length of this ruler is known. It is a known length that is maybe equal to 1 millimeter or 0.1 millimeter. That is of different dimensions. So this is a stage micrometer. The total length of the stage micrometer is here 1 millimeter, which is divided into 100 divisions. And we all know that 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 microns. So 100 divisions is corresponds to 1000 microns. Thereby, each division of stage micrometer is equal to 10 microns. So this is a known value. By using the stage micrometer, now we have to coincide or align the scale of eyepiece micrometer. Here I have shown the stage micrometer is superimposed over the or coincides or aligned over the eyepiece micrometer. So in eyepiece micrometer, the 100th division of eyepiece micrometer is aligned with the 95th unit of stage micrometer. By using the formula stage micrometer divided by eyepiece micrometer into 10 microns, we'll be getting one value that is 9.5 micron, which means the each division of eyepiece micrometer is equal to 9.5 microns. This is known as a calibration factor. By using this calibration, we can measure the length and width of phloem fibers in crude powder flow dress. So the same eyepiece, when we are focused at high power, that is 40x, it will look like this. The divisions of the stage will be enlarged. So if you are going to measure the measurements in low power, you have to calibrate in low power, and that calibration value should be used for calculation. But if you are measuring the size of the tissues or size of the cells, means we have to, if you are calibrating in high power, the calibration factor has to be used for further calculation. Here I have focused the phloem length of the phloem fibers in the powder characters of chinchona bark. For example, if the length of the fiber is showing 20 division and width of the same fiber is showing 4 division, it will be in divisions that has to be converted into micrometer. So for this, we have to multiply by using the calibration factor which you have calculated in low power. So this is a table. Likewise, we have to measure the length and width of phloem fibers of 25 fibers. And we have to calculate like this way. So first, if you are measuring the length of the fibers of 20 divisions, that has to be converted into micrometer by multiplying with the calibration factor. We have calculated calibration factor as 9.5. So we will be converting these 20 divisions into micrometer, which is of about 190 micrometer. Similarly, for a width of the fibers also, we have to convert into micrometer by multiplying with the calibration factor. So like this, we have to measure for 25 fibers. So then the report among these 25 fibers, which fibers is having the maximum value and which is having the lowest value, and we have to take the average of the fibers and we have to give the report, the minimum length of the fiber, maximum length and average length of the fibers. Likewise, the minimum, maximum and average width of the fibers has to be reported. Thank you.